do the best they can to win this match.
Exactly right. This match shown in the many thousands of homes across the tri-state area. And a ranking match for the tri-state, vacant tri-state championship. Outlaw Don Bass taking the man down with the hair, I thought. But Outlaw Don Bass, on his return to championship wrestling, has yet to be defeated here on television. And that holds true with Prince Sifa'afa. There is a good shot of the Outlaw. And Bobby, it's going to be interesting for the fans to watch this match because of the, as we mentioned earlier, the converse in style of the two individuals. Both men, Prince Sifa'afa, using a variety of aerial maneuvers, some very unorthodox but effective maneuvers, whereas Don Bass is the slow, methodical type of wrestler that we have seen many, many times before. So it's going to be very interesting to see which style wins out in this particular encounter.
Yes, it is, Jim. You know, Sifa'afa, he was a very, very successful amateur wrestler, too, but we haven't seen him use too much amateur moves on championship wrestling, Jim. And I think he's trying to fight fire with fire when he goes in the ring against a guy like the Outlaw Don Bass. But as you mentioned earlier, the guy does have a lot of maneuvers. He has a lot of ability, and he can do a lot of different things.
He certainly can. And Bobby, if we put this match into perspective right from the start, Outlaw Don Bass, granted, is the much more experienced performer in the ring. He is the more experienced athlete. Prince Sifa'afa has walked through the competition here on television, but he really hasn't beat anyone that you would have to consider a top contender for the tri-state championship. If I hope my mind is holding true, that I can't remember him defeating a top man here on television. However, Don Bass would fit into that mold, and it's going to be an interesting challenge for the Prince from Samoa.
Yes, it is, Jim. As you said, plus Sifa'afa is giving away about 25 or 30, 35 pounds because Don Bass weighs about 260, 265, the more experience, and I'm sure he's going to utilize that before this match is over.
Well, Prince Sifa'afa, I would think, would need to not battle Outlaw Don Bass on his terms. He needs to use his scientific maneuvers and his speed and quickness to offset this man's size and strength advantage. Bass throwing off into the ropes. High backdrop, and off it goes down. Bass now taking over on the young prince from Samoa, working on the back. Bobby, I was talking with Leroy McGurk earlier in this program, and we're very excited. Coming up next will be the debut of Jimmy Snuka, a man that has held many, many titles, and we're looking forward to that great encounter.
Yes, Jim, I know Snuka from, about 1974 when I was in Japan with him. The guy is a high flyer. He is a very, very good wrestler. He can mix with the best of them, and he doesn't hesitate to use any kind of tactic to win a match. He'll stay in the ring with the best of them. He's from Samoa. He weighs about 235 pounds. And he's a very conditioned man.
Well, Jimmy Snuka, of course, will be here next. Outlaw Don Bass now pulling the hair of the Samoan Prince Sifa'afa and taking the man down to the mat as referee Lou Campbell surveys all the action. Don Bass, another man known to use any trick it takes to wrap up a victory.
This is what we're talking about, Jim, where the experience is paying off for Don Bass right now.
Bass is controlling the tempo of the match, and Bobby, it is a slow, methodical tempo, much like the style that Bass likes to utilize and often needs to pick up the pace here, which he is attempting to do, and often now trying to gather his resources. And this man is in tremendous condition, wrestling fans, as probably as well-conditioned as anyone you'll see in wrestling. Afa bringing Outlaw Don Bass from that corner in a very abrupt manner and backing the Big Outlaw into the corner. Offa now paying Bass back for some of the tactics that he has been utilizing, and Bass rakes across the eyes. Bass attempting to slow the tempo down once again.
Well, that we're going back to the experience again, Jim, and this is where Bass has got the advantage.
Don Bass caught catching off of that elbow for a two count, and Bass going back for that rear chin lock. Bass leaning on the man with all that weight, 259 pounds. Bass weighed in before this television taping. Bass with that rear chin lock, and he has it firmly secured, and Offa trying to determine a way to escape from this particular maneuver. Bobby, we also have Ali Bay coming up later in this hour, the tag team partner of El Toro, and also under the managerial talents, and I use that word loosely, of Billy Starr.
Jim, I know this Ali Bay very well. I have refereed many, many matches for him, and he is a tough customer, and I want to tell you, because
we got both men going over that rope. We've got both men going over that rope, Bobby. Can't be a disqualification, but they're really going at it on the floor. Going at it on the floor. Someone has got to get back in that ring. Referee Lou Campbell can do nothing but count. And Campbell kept counting, and that's all. Both men going out onto the floor. Both men counted out in this encounter. Both men counted out by referee Lou Campbell after both participants went over that top rope. And we have a double disqualification, double count out, and we'll be back with the debut of Jimmy Snuka against Jerry Lanthrop right after our next commercial timeout.
What really happened? Yes, the thing was, I understand that we were both knocked out and the first man up to the feet was the winner. Well, I was the first one up. Now, I don't like to win a match actually like that. And when they explained to me what happened, they said, well, he wants a return match. Well, I'll tell you what, Fargo, I want to be a true champion. I want to go in that ring and show the people that I can beat you right in the middle of the ring. Like you said, the first men go to the hospital, it's the winner. I'm going to tell you what. Monday night, I'm going to put it up, and like you requested, a lumberjack match, brass knuckles match. Well, it's on here in Tulsa.
That is Fairgrounds Pavilion Monday evening at 7:30 p.m.
From the Fiji Islands, weighing 250 pounds, Jimmy Snuka. In the blue corner from Benton Harbor, Michigan, weighing 221 pounds, Jerry Lanthrop.
Jerry Lanthrop taking on the very impressive Jimmy Superfly Snuka here on Championship Wrestling. As Snuka prepares to get out of his wrestling outer attire for this encounter against Jerry Lanthrop. And you can see, wrestling fans, the tremendous, just tremendous muscle definition of this outstanding athlete from the Fiji Islands, Jimmy Snuka. And the fans here in our television sports studio giving Snuka a little difficult time as he prepares to go against another newcomer from Benton Harbor, Michigan, Jerry Lanthrop. Referee Neely calls for the bell. And Bobby, this should be a tremendous treat for our wrestling fans, because Jimmy Snuka has to be considered a world-class professional wrestler.
Yes, he is, Jim. He's been in the top 10 for the last 5, 6, 7 years. He's a fantastic wrestler, and he can stay, as I said earlier, Jim, he can stay in there with the best of them.
Jimmy Snuka, and we'll be talking with Jimmy. A tremendous chop from Snuka right across the chest of Jerry Lanthrop. Snuka, a former holder of the United States Heavyweight Championship, also a partner with Ray the Crippler Stevens, probably the most sadistic wrestler in wrestling today, Ray Stevens. And they held the Mid-Atlantic and World Tag Team Championship. And more recently, for you fans that may watch championship wrestling from Georgia on Superstation Channel 17, Jimmy Snuka and Terry Gordy, a former Freebird, held the, and very successfully, I might add, the Georgia Tag Team Championship. So Jimmy Snuka comes here with a tremendous reputation. And Jerry Lanthrop, Bobby, certainly has his work cut out for him today.
Yes, he does. For him to be making his debut on championship wrestling, Jimmy, he drew a tough opponent.
Snuka, tremendous physical specimen. And Snuka with that chop right across the chest. And we have talked about the converse styles of Prince Sifa Afa. Another man with a very unique style is Jimmy Snuka. And not only can this man fly, Bobby, but he is also a tremendous battler. He does what it takes to win.
That's right, Jim. I don't know if you noticed, but when he threw that Lanthrop into the ropes, he picked up a little more momentum by doing a complete 360. And when Lanthrop came off of the rope, he had everything going that could have put Lanthrop away.
And Bobby, another thing that we want to talk about, and something very important that we need to remember is the fact that some of the rules in the National Wrestling Alliance, we have rules that are becoming very, very stringent. The referees are instructed to do, but something that has become a point of emphasis is coming off that top rope. Coming off the top rope used to be an automatic disqualification at any time. But now they have modified that rule, to my knowledge, to where if a wrestler comes off the top rope with the point of the knee or point of the elbow, it is a disqualification. But coming off with the head or the flat of the body is not. And the reason I'm bringing this up is because Jimmy Snuka is one that likes to go to that top rope for many maneuvers.
Yes, he does, Jim, and he does it quite often. And it really is up to the discretion of the referee if the guy, if he intends to maim the guy in any kind of way with the, like you say, with a knee or the foot or the elbow.
Well, Jimmy Snuka completely dominating this man. Jimmy Snuka has dominated this man from the outset. A backbreaker, and it has been a
here he goes now, Jim. He's going to that top rope. And this is what Jim was telling you about a while ago.
A tremendous maneuver by Jimmy Snuka on the top of Jerry Lanthrop. No one gets up from that maneuver. And that is all for Jerry Lanthrop, the winner. Superfly Jimmy Snuka. And Bobby, I'll make my way to ringside now for a word with this tremendous athlete.
Okay, Jim. The guy really should get flying pay as high as he came off of the top rope. And now Jim Ross is going to the ringside with an interview with the great Jimmy Snuka.
Wrestling fans, you saw the debut of Superfly Jimmy Snuka in very impressive fashion here on Championship Wrestling. A man that has a worldwide reputation. We've talked about the many, many titles that he has held. A tremendous athlete. A man that has come to this area, I know, for one reason, the vacant Tri-State Championship. Mr. Snuka, that championship is vacant. I understand that is exactly why you're here.
I have been around so many places. I just came on a tour back from Japan, Tokyo. And I'm looking forward. And I'm here today for one reason, just like you said. I have held many belts all around the country. You name it. I've been there. You name it, I had it all. And now, like you say, we got a belt that's up. And that's why I'm here for Mr. Announcer. For one reason, one purpose only. And that's to challenge anybody that wants to go against the Superfly. And just remember one thing. That's why I'm here. And I'm here to meet the best. Because I am the best.
Top competition coming this area very, very soon. I'm sure you're ready to withstand any challenge from anybody at any time.
Anytime, any place, anywhere, you name it. That's why I'm here. The Superfly. The greatest one that was born in the Fiji Islands, which is the paradise of the South Pacific. And the Superfly is here to prove one thing to you people. You have seen the greatest. You probably have seen the best. but you're looking at the greatest of them all. Do you understand? Remember that. You remember this face, this body, and remember this voice. And keep your eyes glued on this face.
Wrestling fans, the strong comments of the Superfly, Jimmy Snuka. We'll be hearing much more about him in the upcoming weeks, and we'll be back with more live wrestling right after this.
From Istanbul, Turkey, weighing 252 pounds, Ali Bey, with his manager, Billy Starr. In the blue corner, from Fort Smith, Arkansas, weighing 229 pounds, Gary Black.
Gary Black has his work cut out for him here on Championship Wrestling as he goes against a man short in stature, but a very strong man in Ali Bey, another man that has come to this area, who came with El Toro and Billy Starr bringing these men in here. And we really don't know the mythology behind Billy Starr's ideas in bringing these two top men into this area. However, after this match, immediately following this match, we'll be talking with Billy Starr, and we hope to find out more concerning the arrival of these two men. And Bobby Whitlock still with us here at Mike's side. And Bobby, throughout your travels in professional wrestling, which has taken you to foreign countries and all across the United States, I know that this man, Ali Bey, is no stranger to you, and he has a great reputation.
Yes, he does, Jim. He's a very, very tough wrestler. He's built like a fire plug. He's about 5'9", 5'10", weighs about 252, 55 pounds, something like that. And he knows how to use his weight advantage, and he knows how to wrestle, and the guy is a tough customer.
He certainly is, and Bobby, here's a man that is short in stature and a man that is very, very difficult to handle, to maneuver around because of his low center of gravity. And at this present time, Gary Black has never been in this match, and Ali Bey very easily picking up Gary Black, draping him over that top rope.
And that's 229 pounds. He picked up like 10 pounds, Jim. He had no problems. The guy is very, very strong, and he knows how to. He knows what to do with his strength.
Suplex, belly-to-belly suplex, a Greco-Roman maneuver that Ali Bey, and Bobby, he will use a variety of suplexes throughout his matches.
Yes, he does, Jim, and he knows them all, and he has them all down pat, and he wins a lot of matches with suplexes.
Ali Bey and Black trying to gain some momentum and slow down the onslaught of the man from Istanbul, Turkey, 252 pounds, Ali Bey. And Ali Bey catching Black coming off those ropes. Ali Bey going for the pinfall. Referee Luke Campbell down, looking to see if it is indeed a pinning predicament. Ali Bey and Gary Black, and Ali Bey running across the ring, solidly planting that foot to the head of Gary Black, and yet another time.
Jim, Ali Bey has had this match under control from the opening bell, and right now he's complete control of the match. And I tell you, I don't look for Gary Black to last too long against the ability of Ali Bey. There was a nice arm drag by Gary Black.
And Bobby, that's not to be very derogatory in all the true sense of the word against Gary Black, but he is in there against a very, very tough man.
Right, Jim, and you just got to tell the people like it is. I think Gary Black is a little overmatched in this, as the people can see for themselves.
And this maneuver right here, Bobby, this claw maneuver, this man has got a tremendous grip, and look, wrestling fans, where he has that claw implanted. And if you don't think that doesn't hurt, just try it on someone sometime. That
Go get
maneuver,
your mother or your father and try it on them, see how long it before they slap you.
And Gary Black, in this situation, a slap is not going to do anything to deter the efforts of Ali Bay. And Ali Bay has got this man in a potentially conceding position.
You can see how he has his fingers dug into the man's armpit there, Jim. And I don't think he can last much longer.
The muscles in that particular part of the body are very, very tender, wrestling fans. And Ali Bay Black is submitting right there, or the referee is stopping the match. The referee stops the match. The winner is Ali Bay. And now I make my way to ringside, Bobby. Wrestling fans, you have seen Ali Bay here on his debut on Championship Wrestling. And Billy Starr, the star child, we have talked about these two men that you have brought into this area. The wrestling fans, I'm sure, are as interested as I am to find out exactly what the mythology behind your bringing in these two tremendous athletes to this area.
Well, Ross, I'm going to tell you very simple. You know, and the people right here seen on television what Ricky Romero did to me. He fractured my arm, him and Youngblood. Well, I can't beat them all. I can't fight them all. I got Youngblood, I got Romero, you got Mark Romero, you got a whole family. You got Chief Frank Hill, you got Tom Jones. These people are trying to put me out of professional wrestling. You know that, I know that. Now guess what? My main men, Ali Bay and El Toro, know that. You know, I went to great expense. I had to call this man in Turkey. Long distance, many times. And this man right here in Spain. But finally, I got him. What I wanted to bring to the tri-state area to get even with you, Romero, once and for all, baby, for what you did to my arm. The three of us together will destroy anyone, any place, any time that you put up against us. Look at that. 252 pounds of walking, talking, death and destruction, baby, at 260. Look at that. Look at them arms, baby, right there. These are nothing but the finest professional wrestlers that I personally could find to help me get rid of you, Romero, you, Youngblood, and anybody else that gets in our way. And you can take that to the bank, baby.
There you hear the comments of the manager, Billy Starchild, with a very impressive team. Ali Bay and El Toro. We'll hear more from them in all certainty, and we'll be back with more live wrestling action right after our next commercial. Time out.
From Washington, D.C., weighing 239 pounds, Pork Chops Cash. His partner is from Jackson, Mississippi, weighing 270 pounds, Larry Wright. The team in the blue corner from Amarillo, Texas, at a combined weight of 445 pounds, the father and son team of Ricky and Mark Romero.
Ricky and Mark Romero here on Championship Wrestling. The first time we have seen them in tag team action together, wrestling fans. As Mark Romero goes against Larry Wright to start things out in this tag team confrontation. Arm drag takedown and another one by Romero. As he is completely dominating thus far, the much bigger man in Larry Wright, 270 pounds from Jackson, Mississippi. Just a bad old boy from down south, Bobby. Larry Wright. Arm bar applied to Larry Wright. Romero takes him over, and Wright takes Romero over, rather, and Romero holds on to that arm. There you see the very controversial and vociferous Pork Chops Cash. A man never at a loss for words. Even though I've never heard him say anything really intelligent, but he is never at a loss for words.
You might classify him and Billy Starr in the same category. I'd like to put him in a talking contest, see who could out-talk who.
That would be very interesting. That'd be very interesting indeed. And Ricky Romero making the tag with his son. Bobby, this is the first time that these two men, father and son, have tag teamed here on Championship Wrestling, and that's got to mean something very special for both individuals. Both men, first time they've been on television together. It's got to be something, I think, very special.
Yes, Jim, it is. You got a father-son combination in there, and then you got the experienced Pork Chop Cash against the big 270-pounder as his partner, Larry Wright. Now I think we're really going to see a confrontation here between Ricky Romero and Pork Chop Cash, because Pork Chop Cash, I think he might slow the pace down a little bit and try to get back in the groove and get the match under control.
Pork Chop Cash likes to take advantage where he can, and he did not come out on the better end of that exchange from the very experienced Ricky Romero. Romero, the former Western States heavyweight champion. I would say, Bobby, this wrestling card here today has a very international flavor. We've got men from all over the world here on Championship Wrestling this hour.
Yes, we do, Jim. And that Jimmy Snuka was very impressive with that big dive over the top rope. El Toro was very impressive, and so was Ali Bay.
Well, they are certainly men to be reckoned with, as are Pork Chops Cash and many others that we could name. Big Larry Wright took a bump on the head. Compliments of Ricky Romero. There you see Ricky Romero, the very colorful man, born in Mexico, now making his home in Amarillo, Texas. Pork Chops Cash firmly implanting that right hand to the face of Romero. Romero tagging in his son, cutting him off very quickly as Pork Chops Cash, before the momentum can change. Bobby, there's where experience has a great advantage.
Yes, it does, Jim. And they took over on the younger Romero there with the experience of Pork Chop Cash, and now they have the younger Romero in the corner, and they have him in a little trouble, Jim.
Big Larry Wright, 270 pounds, coming into the ring, and he's laying those elbows right to the back. Now a body slam. It looks to be a body slam by Wright. Wright drops that big leg, tree-like leg, over the chest of young Mark Romero, 19 years old, Bobby. 19 years of age.
Yes, the guy has a future in professional wrestling, Jim. He's a big, tall boy. He gained a few pounds and a little more experience, and I think he's going to be a top contender.
I agree wholeheartedly. And there is his father, Ricky Romero, as Wright very cautiously works his way to the sanctuary of the corner. This is one fall, wrestling fans, or television time remaining. Romero using his experience now. Romero going behind very quickly in a pinning predicament is Larry Wright. However, he does go into the ropes. The referee calls for the break. Both men circling each other, sizing each other up. And it wouldn't take too long to size up that 270-pounder, Bobby, as far as I'm concerned.
No, not really, Jim, because if he can manage to stay in there long enough, that weight advantage is going to be an advantage to him.
Wright picking up Mark Romero, body slamming the young man from Amarillo. Mark Romero going through the legs, using his quickness, tagging in his father, Ricky Romero. Romero catches Wright with that big fist, and coming right down on top of him, he may have a pinning predicament, and he has. The winning team right here. The winning team right here of Mark and Ricky Romero on Championship Wrestling, and we'll be back with closing comments right after our final commercial timeout. I think you'll certainly agree today's hour of Championship Wrestling action has certainly been an exciting and very interesting hour of wrestling action. We've seen several new faces here on Championship Wrestling. including the debut, and very impressively, the debut of the Superfly, Jimmy Snuka, the former United States heavyweight champion, the Mid-Atlantic Tag Team champion, and the Georgia champion, Jimmy Snuka, here on Championship Wrestling. He says he's here for one reason, and one reason only, and that is the vacant Tri-State Heavyweight Championship. Also, the tremendous duo brought in by Billy Starchild to avenge the broken arm suffered at the hands of Ricky Romero and Jay Youngblood, the great combination of Ali Bay. Ali Bay and El Toro now under the managerial talents of Billy Starr. That was an exciting confrontation, and I know we're going to hear more about those two men and probably Ricky Romero and Jay Youngblood as the weeks progress. It's been an exciting hour of wrestling action. We'll have more for you next week. So for Bobby Whitlock, Leroy McGurk, I'm Jim Ross saying thanks very much for being with us, and we'll see you right here next week for more Championship Wrestling.